In our previous videos, we explored various CSS mask properties, including mask image, mask size, mask position, and mask repeat to create eye-catching reveal effects. Today, we'll take it a step further by diving into the mask composite property. We'll discover how to combine multiple layers of CSS masks to create unique patterns and stunning visual effects. Welcome to Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development one step at a time. If you haven't watched my previous videos on CSS masking, I recommend checking them out to understand the basics and explore different reveal effects. Let's begin with a super simple example to understand how CSS mask compositions work. In the HTML, we have an empty element that will serve as our playground. Moving on to the CSS, the card class is styled with a maximum width of 70 VW, a height of 70 VH, and a gradient background. Now, let's implement the mask image property. For this example, we'll use a multi-layered gradient mask. The first layer is a radial gradient with a circular shape. The first color spreads from the center to cover 60% of the card, while the second color, which is fully transparent, begins at the same point and extends to the edge. As expected, the opaque portion remains visible, while the transparent part is hidden. For the second layer of the mask, we'll use a linear gradient. This gradient has three color stops. The first section, which is transparent, spans from 0% to 45%. The opaque section follows, covering 45% to 55%, and then transparency takes over again from 55% to the end. This creates a horizontal bar across the middle of the card. And by adding a 45-degree angle, we transform this bar into a diagonal shape. Before we move further, let's take a moment to understand the basics of the mask composite property. This property defines the compositing operation applied to the current mask layer in relation to the layers beneath it. In simple words, it allows us to control how multiple mask images with different shapes are combined into a single mask. For example, in this case, we have two mask layers. The first layer creates a circle, while the second forms a diagonal bar. When combining multiple layers, the top layer is referred to as the source, and the layers beneath it are called the destination layers. Since the circle is placed on top, it will be treated as the source, while the diagonal bar is the destination. The mask composite property accepts one or more keyword values to define how these layers are combined. The first operation is add, which is also the default value. It indicates that the mask layers will be composited using the add operation, placing the source layer over the destination. In other words, it stacks the top mask layer over the others to form a single mask image. The second operation is subtract. In this case, the source layer is visible only in the areas that fall outside the destination layer. In simpler terms, it removes the destination layer from the source. The third operation is intersect. This displays only the pixels where the two mask layers overlap. And the last one is exclude. This operation combines the non-overlapping regions of the source and destination layers into a single image, leaving the overlapping areas excluded. This explanation covers two layers, but when dealing with more than two layers, the compositing process happens in stages, starting from the bottom and working upward. In the first stage, the second layer from the bottom is treated as the source, while the bottommost layer is the destination. These two layers are composited, and the result becomes the new destination for the next stage. In the second stage, the third layer from the bottom becomes the source, and it is composited with the result of the first stage. This process continues, with each subsequent layer becoming the source and being composited with the result of the previous stage, until all layers are combined. Let's reset the example and add a third layer to the mask. This layer is similar to the second one, but has an angle of minus 45 degrees. As we saw earlier, the add operation is the default, combining all layers into a single mask image. For this example, the composition will be performed in two stages. In the first stage, the third layer, the bottommost, serves as the destination, and the second layer becomes the source. The third layer is subtracted from the second layer, and the result becomes the destination for the next stage. Then, the result of the first stage will be subtracted from the top layer because, in the second stage, the top layer acts as the source. For the intersect operation, the overlapping pixels of the third and second layers become the destination for the second stage. After that, the overlapping pixels of the top layer and the result of the first stage determine the final outcome. Similarly, for the exclude operation, the non-overlapping pixels of the source and destination in the first stage form the destination for the second stage. In the second stage, the non-overlapping pixels of the top layer and the result from the first stage create the final mask image. And that's how the mask composite property works behind the scenes to combine multiple mask layers. Next, just like we played with the mask size property in previous videos, we can apply a similar approach to turn this into a repeatable pattern. In this case, we set the width of the mask image to 50 pixels and the height to 100 pixels to create a horizontal pattern. This can be transformed into a vertical design by simply interchanging the values. And if you want to fill the entire box, using the same values for both width and height will create a seamless, visually appealing pattern. Now let's look at another example of a reveal effect using the mask composite property. We'll use the same HTML from our previous reveal effect video, a hero section with two slides stacked on top of each other. In the CSS, we convert the parent element into a grid container with a single column. Using the grid area property with the value of 1/1 is an easy way to stack grid items. The images are set to cover the entire box by using the object fit property. Next, the second slide, which is visible on top, will host the mask property. This uses four gradient layers for the mask. The first layer moves from bottom to top, the second layer goes from top to bottom, the third layer moves from right to left, and the final layer moves from left to right. The custom property uses the length data type with an initial value of 120 pixels. And when the element enters the hover state, the value is updated to 30 pixels. As usual, the transition property is applied to animate the change. And this is what the front end looks like. A cutout in the top layer allows the bottom layer to peek through. When we hover over the image, the cutout area expands. Now, if we set the mask composite to exclude, it turns the mask into a checkered design. In this example, the mask composition works in three stages. In the first stage, the bottom layer is treated as the destination, and the third layer is the source. This combines all the non-overlapping regions of the source and destination into one image. In the second stage, the previous result becomes the new destination, and the second layer is treated as the source. And in the final stage, the outcome of the second stage serves as the destination, while the top layer is the source. The final result of the composition operations will be the non-overlapping pixels from all the stages combined. And that's how we can mix and merge multiple layers of CSS masks to create unique visual effects. By using properties like mask composite, we can add depth, complexity, and creativity to our designs. This provides a wide range of possibilities for creating visually striking effects without relying on any third-party library. Allow me to mention it again. If you haven't watched my previous videos on CSS masking and related effects, feel free to check them out for in-depth tutorials and more cool techniques. They'll help you build a solid foundation and give you even more ideas for your next projects. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, share it with your fellow developers, and subscribe to stay updated. Share your suggestions or feedback in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.